Hi, my name is Cole from FCP Euro, and today I'm going to show you how to replace your engine air filter on your Mk8 Volkswagen Golf R. In front of me, we have an engine air filter that's made by Hengst. Hengst is the OEM supplier for Volkswagen Automotive Group, so this is the same brand of filter that comes in your car from the factory. Now, what is an engine air filter? This is going to filter all of the air that is being sucked in through our intake pipes and is filtered to the engine so it can breathe, and then take that air, mix it with the fuel, combust, and that's where we have the power from the engine. Now, if this is clogged, we can have some symptoms. A car could be choking, or it could be having a very laggy throttle response if this is filled with dirt, debris, leaves, and stuff like that. The service interval for this by Volkswagen is 60,000 miles in every 6 years. However, here at FCP Euro, we kind of think that interval can be modified a little bit depending on your driving conditions, where you live, or the environment of what you're putting the car through. So we recommend anywhere from 20 to 30,000, but it can go all the way to 60, depending on what kind of conditions it is. This DIY is something that is pretty simple and requires minimal tools and little effort to do something that can definitely take care of your car at the end of the day. So let's transition to over what kind of tools we have to need for the job, and let's get into it. So I have a small 90 degree pick, a set of hose clamp pliers, however you can use generic pliers. For the screws, I have an electric screwdriver and a T25 bit. And I have a very small torque wrench because it's a very small torque spec on those bolts. Now, the bolts can be stripped very easily, so we want to show you the proper torquing procedure. However, it's not required. And for the T25, you can use a screwdriver, socket, or anything that will reach to the hardware down on the airbox. Now that we've gone over all the tools, let's hop in our DIY. Now that we're in the engine bay, the first thing I'm gonna do is take my 90 degree pick and remove this hose here on the airbox. Now I'll take the tip of the pick and get underneath the hose and just crack it free like that. Be careful, this can be stuck on to the airbox sometimes, so take the inside of the pick and make sure it goes all the way around the inside of the hose to break that free. I'm gonna grab my hose clamp pliers and remove the clamp for the intake. I'm gonna snatch it tight, put it up a little bit, and I like to remove my clamps altogether, but keep that on the intake itself. Once that's removed, I can take this and put it off to the side. I like facing it downwards so there's no chance of anything falling in. You can also put some rags or shop towels in it, but you have to remember to take them out before you reassemble. Next, I'm going to take my T25 screwdriver and remove the 8 T25 screws from the airbox. Now that I have the cover off, I can remove this engine air filter. And since I've never seen this before, I'm a little curious to how it looks. Would you look at that? There's definitely some dirt in here. Yeah. Now, I've seen much worse as far as kind of clogged goes, but I think this warrants us replacing this. All right, now that we have our old air filter removed and my new Hengst filter in my hand, we're gonna be replacing and installing it. Before we do that, one thing I like to do is vacuum out the airbox and all the debris in there so it gives our new air filter the best conditions possible to stay clean as long as we can. All right, now that we have that all vacuumed out, we can drop our new filter in and start reassembling. All right, so the filter is pretty easy to install. However, if it doesn't go directly in all the way, you can pinch it and it won't filter the air as good because there'll be leaks. So I wanna make sure that it's laying completely flat and it's not having any high spots in one area more than the other, which feels pretty good. Now I'm gonna grab my lid and start installing all the screws. When putting our lid back on, we wanna make sure all of the screws line back up. If you don't have them all the way aligned, you can still sometimes put in a couple, but all of them won't fit. Now with my electric screwdriver, I'm gonna put it on a very low torque setting because I do not wanna go too tight. All right, now that I have all these fastened, I did want to mention that you don't need an electric screwdriver to do this task. You can use hand tools. I'm just using this to speed up the process for y'all. One thing I do want to show you how to do is actually torque it to 1.5 newton meters. Again, this is not required, but since these can be stripped, I wanted to show the proper torque spec for the airbox. This is a very low torque spec, 1.5 newton meters. Now that I have all of my screws tightly fastened, I can start assembling the air intake. Make sure this is all the way pushed in. Another thing I want to note, there are indicators where to align it. You'll see there is a little dash and a little dash on this pipe and the intake, and we want those lined up so they're straight on. I'm going to take my pliers, grab it from the outside again, and slide it back on. Again, with the alignment, I want to make sure that the clamp is centered on that line, just like so. And I want to make sure that it's in the groove that is on the plastic intake pipe. Now that we've successfully installed the air intake, I'm going to take the last thing and just take this rubber hose, slide it on to this plastic nipple on the airbox, make sure it's pushed on all the way. We just successfully installed our engine air filter in our Mk8 Volkswagen Golf R. If you've liked what you've seen in this video, hit that like button. And if you have any questions on what I've covered here, be sure to drop a comment in the section below. And if you want to see a bunch more DIY videos like this on the Mk8 chassis and many others that we have coming to you, be sure to subscribe. Thanks, my name is Cole Evans, and we'll see you next time.